There's something magical about watching a river flow. And the incredible wildlife that it's home to. For most of us, rivers are synonymous to drinking water, while for many, it's a source of livelihood. But what we often fail to acknowledge is that rivers are wild spaces that support an astonishing array of biodiversity. Over the years, I've been documenting two river ecosystems, the Kaveri and Tungabhadra in Karnataka. There's one species that's drawn me to these rivers more than any other, otters. They are shy creatures, yet extremely curious. I still vividly remember the first time I watched them. Heads bobbing in and out of the river. They disappear and reappear in a different place clutching a fish. Their webbed feet and flattened tail make them strong and agile swimmers. Being social animals, they are often found in large groups and spend a lot of time grooming, hunting, and playing together. Otters are like a pack of wild dogs. In fact, locals refer to them as Neer Nai or Cheer Nai, literally translated to water dogs. They are the apex predators of our rivers. When they have spent sufficient time in the waters, they head to their favorite sandbanks. Sandbanks are critical for otters. They love playing on sand. You'd often see them drying themselves after a swim, grooming each other and running around. Otters also use sandbanks for marking their territories. The more I observed otters, the more I fell in love with them. What really fascinates me is how easily otters adapt to human-dominated landscapes. Otters mostly eat fish, and it's no surprise that they are often in contact with fishermen. Most fishermen tend to leave their nets out overnight or for long durations. The fish caught in the nets are easy prey for the otters, and in the process, the nets are often damaged. While most fishermen have learned to coexist in spite of this economic loss, there's always a section who'd rather not see an otter. Retaliatory killings and hunting for meat are not uncommon. If you have walked along a river that's protected, you would notice a thin stretch of vegetation on both sides of the river. These riparian habitats are extremely important for otters. They provide denning sites. Otters build dens mostly along these banks and among boulders. Today, unfortunately, our rivers are no more pristine. They are heavily dammed, extensively mined for sand, and intensively fished. It was these threats that prompted Samoth Kottur, a staunch wildlife conservationist, to conduct rapid biodiversity assessments of the Tungabhadra River and identify a stretch of the river that needs immediate attention and protection.
River is not just a water, it's full of life, it is full of biodiversity. The people watch so many amazing movies, films in Discovery Channel and National Geographic Channel. They're thrilled by seeing that. But we need to tell that the same animals are living right by the side of their village. So then only they start living and they start protecting this wildlife.
Finally, in 2015, the Karnataka Forest Department officially declared the 34-kilometer stretch of the Tungabhadra River from Mudlapur village near the TB dam to Kampli as the Tungabhadra Otter Conservation Reserve.
First and foremost thing is we have put anti-poaching camps, wherein which our people will be stationed in the anti-poaching camps. From there, they used to patrol both the sites of the river Tungabhadra. So they will see it. Nobody should hunt. Nobody should any illegal activity, which in turn causes damage and the threat to the otters.
Watching otters in this reserve fills me with a sense of hope. Hope for the continued perseverance of this utterly beautiful beings in our rivers.